mean, every criticism about the church has been cancelled. Every, for instance, I remember the day that Fini spoke in Mirabello, so it was supposed to be Fini's day to explain his point of view, which, in a way, many Italians wanted to hear what he had to say about this famous flat in Monte Carlo. We talk about real estate all the time, the villa, the and the teacher Uno gave Fini's short, and then for a few minutes, I couldn't believe it, I was watching it. Was Berlusconi's point of view with a stately, sort of statesman voice, and Berlusconi's still images going on, like on a roll, you know, sitting at his desk for a few minutes. No Western country could possibly do that. And there are many, many other examples. So I think he's right. I think I'm irrelevant, and I'm afraid I am. You, a Russian leader, a Russian journalist saying the same thing in front of a crowded room at the London School of Economics, I think, and I'm not exaggerating, he may have problems, serious problems, and many other, it's not the case in Italy. I think he's smart enough to know that it's, the fact that he praises Putin and Medvedev all the time as the quintessential Democrat, to me, is bizarre, but that's something else. I don't think he does because he thinks he cannot do it. I don't think he's an autocrat. He's a post populist. It's a special. Actually, it's Berlusconi. But I don't think he's an autocrat. I don't think he's got. He wants to cancel. Of course, he wants to keep his control of the media the way it is. In Italy, you say every government controls television in a way that the French and the German and the British government don't do, let alone the Americans. But in Italy, it always happened. This time, of course, they control television and they public television and they own private television, or most of it. And some people will say to you, it's fair. It's okay. Say why? Because the left, when they were there, they were controlling TG3 or TG1, and say, okay, the left is a disaster. I mean, it's Tina. I'm not here to say that the left. When they had a chance, I think it's they'll never ever be forgiven for these. When they had a chance for 5 years, immediately they put their own people into riot, not thinking that the moment you lose an election, they will put their own people and have private television as well. And you look at afternoon television, look at the main news bulletin, look at it's the images, it's the stories that don't go out. Quick question, quick answer. I'll do it from here. The lady?
What do you think would turn Italians?
What do I think? To vote him out. I think somewhere, maybe in the center left, maybe in the center, a leader, someone with charisma, should come up and tell us what Italy will be in 2020. We don't know. The book ends with this. It's. I'll read you. Can I read in Italian? Then I'll translate. I think I. It's the answer. No, it's my answer, but it's very. The few. Non è sufficiente essere nuovi. Bisogna sembrarlo. I laburisti di Tony Blair negli anni 90 hanno sconfitto i conservatori quando hanno cominciato a trattare Margaret Thatcher come un simpatico pezzo da museo. I conservatori David Cameron hanno preparato la vittoria elettorale del 2010 riservando ai laburisti lo stesso trattamento. Noi siamo il nuovo, voi avete già dato, grazie, arrivederci. Inutile ricordare a B che le promesse non sono state mantenute. Risponderà che non gliel'hanno lasciato fare, citando errori nel partito, avversari sleali, regole infernali, congiunture internazionali e congiunzioni astrali. Meglio per l'opposizione offrire all'opposizione qualunque sia. Meglio per l'opposizione offrire all'elettorato una controproposta dettagliata, un'idea precisa del paese, un sogno praticabile. L'Italia è un treno fermo in aperta campagna. Il macchinista litiga con il controllore e i passeggeri stanno a guardare, tifando per uno o per l'altro. Il 150esimo dell'anniversario dell'Unità, 1861-2011, trascorrerà tra liti di connazionali ingrigiti e sbadigli sotto tanti giovani capelli scuri. Concentriamoci sul 2020, è un numero esteticamente interessante e in Italia queste cose contano. Berlusconi, no, B, allora sarà un ricordo che si allontana, un incubo per alcuni, un rimpianto per altri, per tutti dovrebbe essere un monito. Quel che conta, come notava Giorgio Gaber, non è Berlusconi in sé, ma Berlusconi in noi. Lo ha intuito anche l'interessato, aperte virgolette, perché i miei concittadini mi apprezzano in numero così elevato? Perché la maggior parte degli italiani nel loro intimo vorrebbero essere come me, chiuse virgolette. Certo, per lui è stato un affare, per noi un po' meno. È l'unico giudizio del libro, questa fine che l'ho letto, questo è finito il libro, per lui quindi non è un libro terzista, no, io sono convinto, per lui è stato un affare, per noi un po' meno. Detto ciò, chiudo con l'italiano, poi riprendiamo con l'inglese, io credo, come le ho risposto, che sia qualcosa del genere, ma deve essere qualcuno che prima di tutto unisca tanta gente con una bella proposta per il paese. Al momento, francamente, mi sembra... Please. On the free press. Well, Mike, you heard my comments. I think we don't have only a problem with television, which I think is unhealthy, and I'm being elegant. Unhealthy and a disaster to me, that the head of a government owns private television and controls public ones. I think it's democratic blasphemy. I think it's anybody, nobody. But I have to say there are other problems. If you're all Italian newspapers, including mine, are owned by big banks and industrial groups, and there are ways a government can show them that is unhappy about what their papers are saying. So the pressure is there as well. But even worse, and that goes from right to left, and that's in, we call them fondo, editorial. You don't have those in Britain, but in Italy there is a long tradition that the front of the paper, there is a sign comment every day. And that's when you write in that very position. It's not only you, it's your paper speaking. So I'm glad that a few days ago, Corriere asked me to write about the state of Italian journalism. And what I say is what really worries me is the Fox Newsization of Italian journalism. I have colleagues on the right and also on the left, I have to say, who believes that if you strongly have a political opinion, journalism is another way of waging your political battle.